I think we need to work on your approach to stress. Perhaps introduce some techniques that would help you avoid...
losing my shit?
Hi, I'm Beverley Andre.
And I'm Dr. Joy Harden Bradford.
And we are fans of Never Have I Ever, specifically of the great relationship between Devi and her therapist, Dr. Ryan.
You know, Beverley, one of the things that I love most about them is that they feel like they're a great match for one another. They have great energy. Historically, for members of minority communities, finding a good therapist match can be especially challenging, given some of the skepticism within our communities and cultural nuances that aren't always included in our professional training.
B.B. Moore Campbell, National Minority Mental Health Awareness Month, was created to get more of us talking about mental health in Black and Brown communities so we can become more aware of resources to share with each other.
Listen, we know finding a therapist can feel overwhelming, but here are some things to think about when looking for a therapist who's the right match for you.
I kind of want to say it feels effortless,
ooh,
right? Yeah. Like, you know, when you get into that room, like, okay, I'm welcomed here, right?
Yes.
Whether it's the decor, whether it's the mood, is it low light? It should feel easy. Not the work, mm-hmm. but the vibes. It mm-hmm. should feel easy. The environment should feel like I'm welcomed here. I feel honored in this space, right? That my voice is empowered in this space. Once I leave the room, my emotions were safe in that room. My thoughts are safe in that room. They're not coming with me and out to the streets because confidentiality is real.
Right.
Right? So I think effortless mm-hmm. is definitely what it feels like for me.
Yeah, and I think it's also important to think about, like, therapy is as different as the therapist who practice it, right? Mm-hmm. Like, we might have the same kind of training, but the way it looks in session could be very different. I think it's really important to find a therapist that you match with because that's where the work actually happens, right? If you don't actually find a therapist who's a good match for you, who you don't feel heard by, you're not going to share the things that you really need to share.
When you sit with the therapist, you are already feeling either comfortable or you're feeling awkward. Most of the times, it's a mix of both, right? Because you're nervous, especially if you're a first timer. But by the time you get to the end of the first session, if it's a consultation, you know whether or not you feel comfortable with talking to that person, if you feel grounded.
It's important to know that you can disagree with your therapist, right? I think sometimes clients come in thinking they have to agree with everything the therapist says, but it's great actually for you to push back on if your therapist says something that you don't completely agree with, to let them know that you actually don't agree with. But so if you find yourself feeling like you can't talk back to them or you're afraid to correct them, that might also be an indication that it might not be a good therapist for you.
Well, first of all, don't ghost your therapist. If you're considering breaking up with your therapist, I would say just bringing it up in conversation with your therapist. But if you choose to, then go ahead and just inform the therapist, like, hey, I don't think this is working for me. I would appreciate a referral. Do you have anybody that you can refer me to? Or I'm just not ready for therapy right now. I don't want to continue.
I also think it's really important to find a therapist who specializes in the thing that you are concerned with, right? You know, so if you are struggling with an anxiety disorder, you want to visit their websites and see if they talk about treating people with anxiety disorders. Mm-hmm. But kind of generally, all therapists are trained mm-hmm. in some of the same things, right? And the different levels or the different degrees indicate maybe how much longer you went to school, whether there was a particular focus. So you're right, like the letters do mean something, but not as much as I think some people think. Mm-hmm. It's important to know that you're not going to click with every therapist, right? Mm-hmm. Just like everybody is not your friend, every therapist is not going to be the right match for you. And so I think it's important for people to know that sometimes you might go to a couple of different people mm-hmm. before you actually find the right one who is a good match for you.